Moment of Truth. What today's video is all about, I'll be changing the suction control valve on my Ford JJ1. Diesel comes in the Isuzu D-Max Rodeo. Is it called a rodeo? I've got no idea. It's raining outside, so. Any case, if you've got a engine model 4JJ1 in your pickup, then you probably have the suction control valve. Now, the first line of 4JJ1s had the little old control valve that was always giving issues and was later replaced with a longer, more sturdy, I guess, control valve. A while ago, I had an issue where my ECU was actually picking up a low fuel return on the fuel filter. I can't remember what it was. But what I did was remove the suction control valve. I pulled it apart, got some circular pliers in there. There's a lot of videos out there of how to do this. They always say it's a non-serviceable item, but believe me, you can service it. So then you polish the port, polish the little piston that goes in it, and then you just shove it back in your vehicle and then off you go. So that I did. I actually even turned it 180 degrees, put it back in. I haven't gotten problems since. This control valve I ordered from Australia because it wasn't available anywhere near me, and they were also asking astronomical prices for it, which I wasn't prepared to pay. So here's the magic little box. So I bought it from a company that, oh no, this is not even the right one. The real one is this one. That's the upgrade part. There's the part number if you guys would like to get one yourselves. Okay, so there's the brand new part. So it also comes with the little adapter, which I'll be putting in. And it's got this turquoise end on it, but it's the longer control valve. Okay, so let me show you. When you're looking in the side here, this is what you're gonna see. So this little monster here, that's your suction control valve. This is the old one, the one with the beige end. So what you're going to want to do is you probably want to take some two plugs out the way. This one clips in right at the top. You just pull the lever and then it comes away. The real struggle begins where you try to get your hand and an Allen key. And yeah, this one is all right. This one at the back is a nuisance. So this little pluggy, same thing. Press down on it, pull back. Might need to wiggle it a bit. That just comes off easily. You probably want to take the battery off before you do this. Now this would just pop out. Wiggle it a bit. There we go, there's some diesel. So this is how that little adapter looks for the end. And that just pops right on there. And until it clips in. All right, now with that little cap on the end, the little gasket on there. You probably want to put some grease on these as well. So let's just see which one goes where. Small one goes on the flatter end and the large one goes in the deep recess. The recess must go toward the control valve. It might seem a little strange that that port looks blocked off from the little cap, but that's fine because it just lets a little amount of diesel through anyway. So that just goes on like that, and then this would go in your vehicle the same way that you pull the old one out.
All right, here we go. You want to get this in carefully. You just have to pop it in once you're there. If it wants to go in, that is, you have to use the new bolts. So there, the suction control valve is in.
So I'm just going to open this little port here. And then cycle the primary pump 10, 11 times. Basically, all you want to do is put your key in, put it to the prime position or run position. You'll hear when the pump stops, there's a little relay that clicks. But the pump also has a slight wind to it. So after that cycled, switch it back off, switch it back on again. You'll hear it start up again. And then go through that cycle about 10 to 12 times. So I closed that little drain port while the pump was priming. Here you go. Moment of truth. I need to crank it for a while. It's nighttime, but eventually what I found with the control valve, as you saw in the previous clip, it didn't want to start. So I noticed I had a leak by the control valve that I just put in. And what I found was, this is why I made this channel, so that you can learn from my mistakes and enjoy some content. I forgot the old O-ring on the pump, which I didn't see. So it didn't properly seal. It couldn't get up to pressure and it didn't want to start. And it actually did leak some diesel through. And I tightened the one corner. It started up eventually, but it was spewing diesel out of where the seal should be. Here I am, hoping it starts. So I'm basically just going through the cycles now still. Switching it off, back on, let the pump run a bit, prime.
Okay. Here we go.
Battery's done. Okay. I'll just let it idle for a while. That's fantastic. It's called a rodeo? I've got no idea. No, it's not the rodeo.
Oh, bugger.